You stop, breathe. I promise you everything's going to be okay. Stop stressing so much, girl. Oh, you'd hear that. Hey, girl. My beautiful Libra, how are you doing? My name is Simply Valka, and today I'm going to be doing your general weekly reading, Libra. Now, I also do your weekly you versus them tarot reading between you and your person, Libra, which I'll leave a link to over here, as well as a couple other videos I've done. I've done your urgent spirit guide messages recently, Libra. I'll just leave all that there, but whenever it comes to my readings, Libra, be sure to take the cards that resonate and leave what doesn't, because put it in perspective, Libra, I'm just a man reading some tarot cards to you. You know your situation better than I ever possibly could, so take the cards that resonate, Libra, and leave what doesn't, because I promise you I'm not going to be offended by it whatsoever. Now, Libra, it's important for me to ask for you to let me know which tarot cards resonate with you in this reading, because I'm a nosy person, really. I like to know what's going on in y'all's lives, and that's how I keep up with y'all's hearing about how the tarot cards resonate with you and y'all's unique situations, right? So, and if you do find some tarot cards that resonate with you, Libra, I would really appreciate it for you to take the time to give this video a like and subscribe, because it does help out my channel a lot, Libra, and I always am super appreciative when you take the time to do that for me. And then finally, Libra, I just want to say this reading here is just to give you some perspective, right? You know, the tarot cards are just here to give you some food for thought, something for you to consider as you go throughout your week, your day, your life, right? So with all that in mind, let's just get into your general reading now, Libra. Now, I pulled some normal tarot cards for you, Libra, but I also pulled a moon oracle card I just felt drawn to, and the Gibbous Moon. It says you're very close to achieving your goal, so I kind of got goosebumps actually getting this card, Libra, because I feel like also looking at the back of the deck, and it says the full moon in Leo, don't let your pride get in the way. We'll put a pin on this for a moment, Libra, just because I feel like it's the relevant message here. When you have the Gibbous Moon, I just get this sense of, like, I feel like I even said this before for you, Libra, in one of your readings. One of you guys will have to let me know, but I feel like I was saying, like, in one of y'all's readings, where it's like the final stretch. I feel like you guys are just going through the final stretch, Libra. And so when I see this Gibbous Moon, one, I read it as just, I mean, self-explanatory, right? It's just like, keep pushing through. But when Spirit brings this along, this does let me know that some of my Libras, they kind of may be waning a little bit in their hopefulness, right? But and it makes sense, right? Because you've just been in this place of working hard, trying to get to achieving your goal that the Gibbous Moon talks about, Libra. But then we have the full moon in Leo, don't let your pride get in the way. Now, Libra, let's break this down. I feel like these two cards are relevant for you just because it's like a combination of where, and I might annoy some of you Libras, but I feel like you understand it coming from another Libra, right? But I get this sense of where it's like, you're so close to achieving your goal. If you were just willing to, like, let down your pride a little bit, even let down the ego a little bit, and just, like, the word shamelessly just keeps coming to mind. So don't feel ashamed about whatever it is that you're working on, Libra, whether it's your feelings, your emotions, your projects, whatever it is, don't feel shame about putting it out there, right? If you, for my perfectionist Libras, if you are like being a little bit too prideful and like putting something out because you just want it to be perfect, that's where your pride gets in the way of stopping you from fully accomplishing your goal. I feel like the best thing you can do this week, Libra, is to really release, really open yourself up, and really just put yourself out there. Like, I feel like the more you put yourself out there right now, Libra, the better off, like, the better received that you're going to be. I really do feel like there's some limiters that you've been kind of placing on yourself, in a sense of where you won't do as much as you could just because you will hone in on maybe too many of the details. It's good to be a perfectionist on some level, but there does need to be a balance, right? Because if you spend too much time trying to perfect things, then you're just always going to be stuck in this Gibbous Moon state of where you're just close to achieving it, but you're just not doing that extra bit, right? So let's get into the tarot side of things for your general reading now. We have the Six of Pentacles coming in, as well as the Four of Pentacles. Beautiful energy. This is just one of those, like, Libra, I feel like, again, of where, you know how I was saying, like, the more you open yourself up, the more you put yourself out there, the better your things are going to be received. The better the results that you get will come, I don't know if that just made sense. I don't know if I just made a proper sentence. The more you effort, more you open yourself up, the more energy that you put out, the more like that's going to be received in a positive way and to really create something beautiful for you. That's what that Six of Pentacles is for. Four of Pentacles is really just like, yeah, more like that proper investment, right? Don't pay attention. Like, you know, it's good to be protective of your pentacles, right? Like this individual is Libra, but don't be so protective of it. Don't be too prideful of those pentacles, right? To not make the investments, to not just put it out there, right? Something I really just want to like push for you, Libra, because I really feel like that's like going to be the main message for this week, regardless of whatever it is we tap into. And then the final two cards for the general messages, we have the World card coming in. This is achievement, Libra, like very big cards, right? Even if you just look at the meanings of the cards themselves, so you know I'm not like fluffing it up, right? The World card is like things just like, I feel like you're getting more in tune or more in sync with the world, with the universe, with the things around you. This is just like that same cliche of where it's just like, I feel like the like things are really starting to manifest for you properly, and you just like, the more you put in, the more you invest, I just promise you the world's going to just receive that and really help you accomplish the achievements, help fulfill you in the places that you want to be fulfilled. And naturally, talking about that fulfillment, we have the Ace of Cups coming in. This is another card talking about fulfillment, another card asking you to open up, your cups filling over, right? But I don't feel like you'll get to this state unless you push yourself more, Libra. And not just in the sense of pushing yourself or just working harder. Just pushing yourself in the sense of, it's going to sound like such a weird message, but create it, right? You know, create something and put it out there. Be okay with the fact that something that isn't perfect in your eyes still is worth being seen, because it's, once it does get seen, like people are going to receive it so beautifully. So all I'm going to say on that, Libra. So let's get into the actual tarot cards. Well, I guess you technically already did get into some tarot cards, but Libra, what I mean now is we're going to get into I'm going to be doing a row, Libra, of tarot cards that just talk about your career and finances, and then we'll get into a row for my Libras interested in social situations, and then after, Libra, we'll just get into some final clarifying thoughts from Spirit. So let's just get into the career financial side of things for my Libras. So the cards that I pulled, we have the Nine of Discs coming in for you, the Emperor card, and then the Four of Discs, or the Four of Pentacles, is following you, Libra. So this is, again, talking about just making the proper investments, right? The Emperor card is the energy that I feel like you're coming into, Libra. More so what it is that you want to exude, right? As the Emperor doesn't feel insecure about the content that they put out there. The Emperor doesn't feel insecure about what it is that they're providing, because the Emperor is aware of, like, they only got to this place that they are now and will get to because of their own capabilities, of their own investments, right? Not really about other people. So really kind of like a calling to acknowledge your own power in that sense, and not being afraid of putting it out there, right? Really, I feel like the don't let pride get in the way is like such a, like, stop feeling like it has to be viewed in such a specific way or it has to be perfect, right? Stop caring about other people's perspectives and how they'll receive it, because they'll receive it beautifully, right? You are being your harshest critic. And then the Nine of Discs is just like that card of, again, just very much so, especially when it's in career, it's that being able to self-sustaining, right? Being able to take care of yourself, being able to, very good for my Libras that are like self-employed, but even in terms of like your job, like for my Libras that are just in their 9-to-5, which is okay, right? I do get this sense of there's some type of opportunity that you could take up to make more money. We'll get into that with your clarifiers. The clarifier that we have for your Emperor card is the Ten of Wands. So this is the obstacle for you, Libra. This is what is going to be the biggest burden for you if we really owning this Emperor energy as much as you would like to, right? That's where it's like, that's where the problem, the burden comes in. Burden comes in for you, because it's like, it's hard to really feel confident in like the stuff that you put out there, especially if you aren't able to really perfect it in the way that you want. But again, I'm going to keep referencing this, don't let pride get in the way, and remembering that you're so close to achieving your goal. Stop. Truly, Libra, I feel like it's just such a, like, just putting yourself out there, really such a heavy, like, fool energy. Like, the best thing that you can do this week is just be the fool. Four of Discs comes in. The clarifier is the Six of Cups. coming in here. So this is something, this is more so in regards to like the successful projects, or more so projects and things that a Libra has been working on for a long time now. This isn't really like money that's just, or abundance, or money or finances coming in just out of the blue. This is something that you've been putting a lot of investments, a lot of time and energy into. So it's more so like think more so like in the big scheme of things. What is it that you've been trying to work towards that is big, that would affect your finances or your work situation, Libra, right? And then for your Nine of Discs, we have the Eight of Swords coming in here. So what I'm talking about here, right? This is what it is. You're trying to be self-sustaining, you're trying to be self-sufficient, and then the Eight of Swords comes in is where this is your biggest block, because at some level maybe you don't think that you can, Libra. Maybe there's like this level language with yourself where it's that same thing, Libra, where it's just like with the Emperor and with your Nine of Pentacles, the blockage comes in of your perception of yourself and like the perception of how things like your product would be received or your content would be received, right? That's where the issue is. It's not about the content itself, it's just about you not putting out the content, or you overly stressing yourself out about the content. So wrapping all that up, Libra, we'll get into the social situations now for my Libras interested in their social for this reading. So Libra, we have for you the Knave of Discs coming in here. All right, Knave of Discs. We have the Knight of Swords coming in as well. And then we have the Seven of Swords coming in here. So there is definitely someone wanting to, I do get the sense, Libra, of either or, I guess I'll have a better understanding who it is that wants to communicate, whether it's you or the other person, Libra. But there is some type of someone wanting to communicate with this Page of Pentacles. It's this Knave of Discs in this, but I think it's, I'm pretty sure it's in Page. Yeah, it's Page. Page of Discs for this. This is where it's like someone wants to offer some type of communication, like kind of like wearing their heart on their sleeve or exposing their feelings, right? This card is pretty graphic in that. And then the Knight of Swords is where it's just like there is some resistance here. There's some type of nervousness when it comes to communicating. So I don't know, whoever this person is, it's like this is already of like a storyline of being like, okay, want to open up to Libra. We'll just say someone's wanting to communicate with you, Libra. Someone wants to communicate with you, wear their heart on their sleeves, or really just open themselves up to you, Libra, be having like an honest conversation about feelings. And then they're afraid of the Seven of Swords. They're afraid quite literally of you, Libra, and how you would react, right? They don't want to communicate with you, and then they kind of see you as like taking a sword and just being ready for battle and being like, what's up, right? So definitely interesting. Let's get some clarifiers though, just so we can get a little bit more detail on the soap opera going on here, Libra. We have the Empress card coming in as well. Okay. All right, Libra. We're going to have a little bit of a talk, honey, but not a bad one. The clarifier that we have for your Knave of Disc, or your Page of Pentacles, we'll call it for simplicity, is the Empress card coming in. So whoever is wanting to communicate, they're wanting to communicate after they've kind of learned from their mistakes, or learned their lesson almost. And I guess that language kind of implies that someone did something wrong, which it doesn't have to be the case. But when this Empress card comes in, they've grown. Someone has grown, and that's now they're at a place where they feel ready to bear their heart open for the world to see, or you to see, Libra. It doesn't have to be romantic. It just could just be someone finally trying to get on the same page as you, right? Knight of Swords, the clarification, the Fool. So this is the energy, I feel like, of what someone's trying to build up to, where it is that Fool, where they kind of just like say, you know, screw it, why, like, might as well just shoot my shot almost, right? Might as well just try to hope for the best and communicate. So whoever this is, whether it's you or the other person, Libra, I see some individual kind of just being like, well, let me just try anyways and hope for the best sort of thing. So they end up getting some type of strength or courage just to do this. Another card came out, Queen of Discs coming out as well, right when I was going to talk about the clarifier for the Seven of Swords, which is the King of Pentacles. So it's funny, you have the King and Queen of Pentacles coming in here. This does lead me to believe, Libra, that whoever this person is, it's more than just like a social connection, in that I do feel like they there's more depth to it. Now, what I mean by this, it could be in terms of like, you know, like a work relationship where you guys would be able to work beautifully together, right? Because I know in some of y'all's readings, there has been this presence, there's some type of collaborative energy, someone wanting to collaborate with you, Libra. But this also could just be where it's like, the depth of like a person that like kind of just understands you, right? This would be more so like a situation of where perhaps Libra, you saw a connection with someone or you felt a connection with someone, and then maybe you try to pursue them, right? Maybe you try to have something deeper with them, and then it just didn't work out, maybe poor timing or something like that. And then later on, this person like sees from their mistakes or like has grown further in life and realizes more of like what they want out of life, which would be wanting a Libra, right? Because whoever this person is, like, y'all's energy like match each other nicely. Even if you guys are opposites in the sense of where it's like one person's really introverted and the other person's extroverted, I see you two like really blending or having like the same thought process, I guess, right? So it's just like, well, people wouldn't maybe naturally guess, being like, oh yeah, these people are like best friends or something. Like, once you actually, like, get into the depth of the conversation between you two, you guys just understand each other. You guys bring forth a lot of just stable energy, not a lot of drama. So it's really pleasant in that way. So definitely let me know how this pans out for those that social situation for you, Libra. And then, now, final thoughts from tarot cards to close out this reading for you, Libra. We have the Ace of Discs coming in with the Moon card and the Ten of Discs. So this is really beautiful energy, Libra, because this is, I'm getting like, whenever you see the Moon card coming in, Libra, this is where it's just like something kind of happening, catching you off guard. This is an energy of like waking up the next day, and then, you know, if you have like a store, you just woke up to like 50 new orders, right? It's that kind of energy, especially when you have it paired with the Ace of Discs as well as the Ten of Discs, right? This is really just such a beautiful time, Libra, of this is why you want to put yourself out there, essentially, right? This is because of these three cards. It's because like the more you put yourself out there, the more you kind of get this opportunity to have something happen in your life that really shifts things for you. If you've been resisting perhaps like putting out a product or putting out certain content, Libra, do it, because it's like one of those things, you'll be surprised by how well it sticks, right? Not only will you be surprised by the results, it's going to be pretty insane results, right? When you have the Ten of Pentacles and the Ace of Discs, that's like such abundant energy, I guess. Really, it kind of just adds so much stability in your life. So truly, the biggest thing that I would say, Libra, to do this week is to, as I was saying, like own that full energy. Really, what I would say is to truly just throw a bunch out and see what sticks, truly. I know that's going to be so difficult for some of my Libras, right? Because of their perfectionist nature. But I keep on wanting to reference Full Moon in Leo. Don't let your pride get in the way, honey, because you're so close to achieving your goal. There's literally no reason not to just throw a bunch of stuff on the wall and see what sticks, because even you throwing stuff on that wall, like what doesn't stick is still going to give you some pretty good results. Like, this Moon card lets me know that you don't know the whole story of what's going to go happen, right? You think you know how things are going to be. You may have like a little business plan, Libra, but this Moon card coming in, honey, you're going to be taken off guard in such a beautiful way. So, final tarot card thoughts. We have the Spirit of Swords as well as the Two of Wands. So this is definitely such an energy of truly, I feel like just like a new beginning is coming for you. Like, I feel like whatever after this week, and maybe not even just in this week, maybe in the next few weeks, I would say, Libra, the results that you get from putting yourself out there and like what I'm seeing in the cards, I really just see such a, it's almost just like you're realizing the world is your oyster. You just see so much more opportunity coming your way, so many doors opening for you, and it's going to come from a place of being like, you're going to start thinking, being like, okay, what do I want to do, rather than feeling like you have to think about what do I need to do to get successful, right? It will be only a question of what feels good to you. And I feel like it's just going to be so, you're going to be so pleasantly surprised. So, Libra, that's the cards that I have for you. Hopefully this reading resonated. If it did, be sure to leave me a like and subscribe, and then share my videos with a friend if you think they might be into my messages. Until next time though, Libra, I love you so much. Bye.